I will work for you. Fill my hands with power.
Please be seated. You guys got this. You got this. You ready? We sit here today to celebrate the love between Eric Brandt and Olivia Waddell and to witness their depth of that love as they join together in the commitment of marriage. It's no accident that each of you is here today. And each of you was invited to be here because you represent someone important in the individual and collective lives of Eric and Olivia. I would also like to recognize and honor Olivia's parents, Ron and Don, as well as Eric's parents, Bob and Pam. Eric and Olivia aren't just starting their own family today, they're expanding yours. Your continuous support of the two of them here today and each day forward can only strengthen their bond even further. I know how deeply Eric and Olivia care for and love another, and I feel privileged to be here today among all of you as a witness of their commitment to a lifetime of love to one another. My name is Megan Marks, and I have had the privilege of being friends with Eric and Olivia for several years. When Eric and Olivia first approached me to officiate their wedding ceremony, my first reaction was, "Of course, but are you sure you want me? I have literally never done anything like this before." Needless to say, they're confident in my abilities. If there's one thing I know about the couple, it is that they're extremely nervous about this very moment and aren't too excited to be the center of attention. So I thought I would share some advice that someone once told me in preparation for my own wedding day. They told me that marriage is like a pair of scissors. Sometimes you're going in the opposite direction, sometimes you're going in the same direction. But at the end of the day, you always come together with a really good screw. I'm sorry. But in all seriousness, I didn't know what to do in preparation for today. Where do I start? But as great-grandpa Alphonse always used to say, if you don't know where to start, go back to the beginning. For those of you that don't know, Eric and Olivia swiped right in 2020. I can still distinctively remember the first time Eric introduced us to Olivia, and it was quick. We were very quick to discover that they completed each other and complemented each other very well. In the many years they have known each other, these two have had countless adventures, made joyful memories, and have supported each other through difficult times. And with patience, understanding, laughter, and honesty, they have grown into the couple you see before you. Now, they are ready to spend the rest of their lives together, building new memories as husband and wife. The foundations of a true marriage begin long before the wedding day, and the efforts of marriage continue long after the ceremony ends. A brief moment in time, the stroke of a pen, and hitting enter on the internet is all that it takes to form the legal bond of marriage. But it takes a lifetime of love, commitment, and compromise to make marriage durable and everlasting. Today, you declare your commitment to each other before family and friends. The Friends couple, Jordan Rose, will now share a prayer and a reading.
I will be reading from 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 7. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Please join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day surrounded by Eric and Olivia's loved ones as we celebrate the two of them becoming one. We ask for your blessing and your hand over their marriage. Lord, we ask that your perfect will be done. We ask that you give them wisdom, patience, and grace throughout their life together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jordan. Today, Eric and Olivia will be tying God's knot in a tradition called the cord of three strands. People say it takes two to have a healthy marriage, but in reality, it takes three: one man, one woman, and God. It was God who gave life to Eric and Olivia. It was with the help of God that their parents raised them to be mature and wise individuals. It was God's plan that brought these two together. And as they stand in front of God today to solemnize their relationship, they ask for his blessing and guidance. Eric and Olivia, you may now braid the cords together. As you do so, you acknowledge that the sacrament of marriage is initiated and guided by God himself. You must always put the Lord at the center of your union, as doing so ensures a strong and resilient partnership.
I'm sorry. Doing good. I'm trying to hurry up. You're doing good. Babe, you look so good.
You look really good.
Thanks.
My hands are so sweaty.
We're almost there. Good prayer.
Mm-hmm. It's like we practiced.
It's taking a lot longer. I'm gonna hurry up. Can you get that ready to die?
Sure.
Just tie it tight.
Go around it.
I know.
Let's try this.
The ending of this short but meaningful unity ceremony, let us always remember these words from Matthew 9:16. They are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate.
That's pretty good. Good job.
Thanks.
And now for the vows. Eric, repeat after me. I, Eric, take you, Olivia.
I, Eric, take you, Olivia.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward, till death do us part.
From this day forward, till death do us part.
May you never steal, lie, or cheat.
May you never steal, lie, or cheat.
But if you steal, then steal away my sorrow.
But if you steal, then steal away my sorrow.
And if you must lie.
And if you must lie.
Lie with me all the nights of my life.
Lie with me all the nights of my life.
And if you must cheat.
And if you must cheat.
Then please cheat death, because I couldn't live a day without you.
Then please cheat death, because I couldn't live a day without you.
Olivia, repeat after me.
Okay.
I, Olivia, take you, Eric.
I, Olivia, take you, Eric.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward, till death do us part.
From this day forward, till death do us part.
May you never steal, lie, or cheat.
May you never steal, lie, or cheat.
But if you steal, then steal away my sorrow.
But if you steal, then steal away my sorrow.
And if you must lie.
And if you must lie.
Lie with me all the nights of my life.
Lie with me all the nights of my life.
And if you must cheat.
And if you must cheat.
Then please cheat death, because I couldn't live a day without you.
Then please cheat death, because I couldn't live a day without you.
Now for the declaration of intent. Eric, do you take Olivia as your cherished wife in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by her side through sickness and in health, joy and sorrow, so as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Olivia, do you take Eric as your cherished husband in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by his side through sickness and health, joy and sorrow, so as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And now for the exchange of the rings. The wedding ring symbolizes the never-ending love you two have for one another. By exchanging these rings, you solidify a lifelong commitment to one another. The rings serve as a welcome and constant reminder of the bond you have formed. Thank you. Eric, repeat after me. Olivia, I give you this ring.
Olivia, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle of this ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of this ring completes itself.
You complete me.
You complete me.
Oops. Eric, I give you this ring.
Eric, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
You complete me.
You complete me.
May the sun bring you new energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worries and the breeze blow away new strength into your being. And on all the days of your life, may you walk gently through the world and know its beauty. Now you can feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth for the other. Now there will be no loneliness. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. Now go to your dwelling to enter into the days of your life together. And may your days be good and long upon this earth. Eric and Olivia, by the power vested in me, by the Universal Life Church, and by the state of Wisconsin, and sealed together today, both in law and love before God, I am pleased to pronounce you husband and wife. Eric, you may kiss your bride.